guys, Helena here, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can connect and use the power of AI and connect that to your Google Sheets or Google Doc so that you can utilize the power of AI when you're writing documents and when you're using your spreadsheets. Now, before we get started, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss any new videos that I post. Okay, now let's dive in and take a look at my screen. So right now I have Google Sheets pulled up and I have already gone ahead and installed GTP for Sheets. And if you haven't done this, all you need to do is to go up here and click extensions. Once you click extensions, you want to click on add-ons and then click on get add-ons. Once you are here, you'll be prompted to search for the apps and you simply type in ChatGPT for Sheets and Docs right over here. And once you click on it, you see I already have it installed. Okay, so once you have the app installed, here's what you can do. You will see that the extension has been added to your Google Sheet account and you can simply click launch sidebar here. And this will give you all of the commands that you can do on Google Sheets. Now, if you click on list of GPT function right here, you'll see everything that GPT can now do in Sheets. So let's go over each one of them. The most simple thing is that you can give it a command, just like you could do on the ChatGPT interface. So if I just copy this and paste their example right here. So in this case, we want ChatGPT to write a tagline for an ice cream shop that we're running. And we simply just click enter and boom, there we go. Scoops of happiness in every cone. So I can even tell it to, let's say, write a summary of Romeo and Juliet. So really it's using the same kind of commands that you would on ChatGPT. You can tell it to write something for you. You can tell it to write an email. You can tell it to summarize some sort of text. So it's written a summary here of Romeo and Juliet. It's a tragic play by William Shakespeare to rival families and it kind of just goes on and on. But you can kind of get an idea of how it works. So if you need to write some sort of text in ChatGPT, this is really useful. Now moving on, ChatGPT can also make a list. For example, let's use their example here. It can give me 5 good short ads about spreadsheets. So let's see what happens here. So in this case, what ChatGPT would do is it would list out 5 different ads that you can write about spreadsheets. So see, boom, and it's giving it to you in multiple lines here. Get organized and save time with our easy to use spreadsheet software. Say goodbye to manual calculations and hello to accurate data with our spreadsheet program. So ChatGPT can also help you fill in and clean up data as well. So if you're in a data analyst role, you have a lot of cells to clean up, definitely you need to check out ChatGPT here. So we can just insert their example right here, right? So you can see that they give you a list of names right here, and you can see that some of these names need some cleaning up to do.
Bond. James Bond.
What you could do is just use this ChatGPT command, which is GPT underscore fill, and you simply fill in first good example. So you do the first 2, and then you just drag in all of the other names, and ChatGPT will know how to fix the remaining names. So if I just put random names here, that's not in the proper spelling. You see where that's a formula. And I just extend that down the 2 rows to 27. And you can see now it's regenerating all of the names again. And see, it just fixed the 2 names I just filled. Pretty cool, right? Okay, moving on. ChatGPT can also make a table. So if we copy this command right here, right? In this command, we're asking GPT to create a table of top 10 most eaten fruits and their nutritional data. See? So now we have a list of the fruits, their calorie value, and how many carbohydrates are in it, fiber, vitamin C, and potassium. So really useful. So if you need to create a table of some sort, This is super useful to help you do that. All right, moving on, GPT can also function. So if you wanted to change the format of a date or a currency or something like that, it could help you do that. So in this example, if we're looking at the date format here, it can turn it into this format right here, right? Instead of like saying February 14th, it can turn it into just a slash right there. You can also edit using ChatGPT. You just write something with bad grammar. I'll put, go to mall, something with extremely bad grammar. See, GPT has fixed the grammar for me. It says, I am going to the mall, right? You can also add tags. Not that one, I haven't found it really useful. You can also classify different things. So in this example, I'm classifying a banana. Is it a fruit or a vegetable? And we can ask, and then it returns fruit. All right. Moving on, you can also use GPT for sheets to summarize some sort of text. So the command for this is just GPT underscore summarize. You do the open bracket, you put in all of the long text you want to summarize, and then it will summarize it for you. We'll also see this functionality when we look at GPT for documents as well. And the last thing I'll show you here is that it can also translate. So if I put something in, let's say GPT translate, and I put hello world, and I want them to translate this, let's say, to Chinese. And then wait a second. Boom, I got my Chinese here. So those are kind of like the main functionalities that you can do with GPT for Sheets. Of course, if you just wanted to explore the documents, they have documentation for all of their commands. There's ways that you can combine and mix and match the different commands to do a lot of cool things that just takes your spreadsheet skills to the next level. So pretty cool, right, guys? You can really maximize your utility and productivity at work with the power of using GPT for Google Spreadsheets and for Google Documents. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for joining me, and I'll see you in my next video. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much.